So everyone is on a continuum between mental illness and mental health. And where they go on that continuum is dependent on the stressors that they are experiencing and the way that they cope with those stressors and the things that are available to them in terms of coping. And people can cope in ways that are adaptive, so in ways that in the long term work out for you, and in ways that are maladaptive. And what we've seen in 2020 is that stressors for people of color have gone up, whether it is disparate impact of COVID or unemployment or financial insecurity, or even just knowing people in your family, in your community who are dealing with these things. Well, at the same time, people's coping mechanisms have been taken away. So things like travel, vacation, getting your massages, like all of these things that people normally incorporate into their lives have been taken away at a time when they really need them most. And there's this sort of collective compartmentalization we do in the American society where we are the land of the free, home of the brave, liberty and justice for all, while at the same time, the reality of what this country is founded upon, the gross inequities that are present in every system are always there. So we sort of have to put those in a box in order to be part of this narrative about what America is and is supposed to be. And I think one of the things that's happened with 2020 is it has busted all of those compartments wide open, right? We can't pretend anymore the way that we have as a nation about sort of what we are, the inequities that persist, and the racism that is present in the healthcare system, which is what we've seen with COVID, and in the carceral system, which is what we've seen with George Floyd and with the many other people whose deaths have been highly publicized.